Materials page, you'll have a chance to select the type of fabric and hardware that you want to use. You can install fabric databases from your own fabric manufacturers, or you can create and edit your own, and we'll show you how to do this in a later video. For this example, we'll go with a custom fabric database. Once you've selected your fabric database and fabric type, the rest of the fabric values, the roll width, warp stretch, and weft stretch, will come out of the database automatically. Advanced users may want to override the stretch values, but we won't normally need to do this. The hardware database options are similar. For this example, we'll use a custom hardware database. Then we'll select our default edge type. We'll use webbing. Our default corner hardware, we'll use a D-ring. And our default corner link, and we'll use a shackle. Again, once you've selected these values, the rest of the hardware values, the length and width of the corner hardware, the link, and the hem, will come out of the database automatically. You may want to specify the color or material of the webbing you're using, especially if it is different from the rest of the sail. Moving on to the details section, you'll want to specify the type of thread that you're using, and the internal seam width. This is important if you're making a sail that's made of multiple panels joined together. You'll also want to include any accessories, such as a tag with the manufacturer's label. The visualization poles are poles that the program will add to the 3D model that it creates. It's very important to realize that these poles are for visualization purposes only, and really have nothing to do with the actual structure. So here you select the visualization pole diameter, and then the added height, which is an option to extend the poles beyond the point of attachment with the fabric. You can also apply pole lean to visualization, which will lean the poles outward by about 5 degrees for a visual appeal.